Welcome to our online service today for All Saints Farringdon and St Mary's Little Coxwell. My name is Josie Speller and I'm the Children and Families Leader at All Saints. Steve is on retreat this week, so it's my absolute delight to be leading us through our online service today. And as we come to worship together, we're going to continue to hold in prayer the people of Ukraine through the invasion of their country. And though we'll be praying for them a bit later, let's also begin with a prayer of peace and justice. Let's pray. Loving God, we pray for the people of Ukraine, for all those suffering or afraid, that you will be close to them and protect them. We pray for world leaders, for compassion, strength, and wisdom to guide their choices. We pray for the world that in this moment of crisis, we may reach out in solidarity to our brothers and sisters in need. May we walk in your ways so that peace and justice become a reality for the people of Ukraine and for all the world. Amen. Amen. A bit later in our service, Julia Byrne is going to share our Bible reading, and then Chris Etherton will preach to us. But before that, though, we're going to begin our time of worship by singing together, and our first song is In Christ Alone. It's a great hymn telling the whole gospel story, and if you're watching at home, why not sing it out loud as if you were in church? Let's sing together.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, the fullness of God in helpless play, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I lay. No power of hell, no scheme of
The Holy Gospel is written in the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 13, verses 31 to 35. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Glory be to thee, O Lord. At that very hour, some Pharisees came and said to him, "Get away from here, for Herod wants to kill you." He said to them, "Go and tell that fox for me. Listen, I am casting out demons and performing cures today and tomorrow, and on the third day I finish my work. Yet today, tomorrow, and the next day I must be on my way, because it is impossible for a prophet to be killed outside of Jerusalem. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, the city that kills the prophets and stones those who are sent to it. How often have I desired to gather your children together as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, and you were not willing. See, your house is left to you. And I tell you, you will not see me until the time comes when you say, 'Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.'" This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise be to thee, O Christ.
My wife and I have the privilege of looking after our granddaughter one day each week. She's 3 and a half. Usually she's a joy, but sometimes she's a tad tetchy. Poor Sausage has a lot going on at present. Just started 2 long days at preschool. Moved into a new bedroom to make way for baby sister or brother due next month. And however gently we decline her request for another snack, or have to tell her not to do something in the interests of her safety, ours, or that of others, however gently she can react by saying, "Go away," accompanied by a grumpy face. And hey, does she do a good grumpy face and folded arms and turning her back? I long to give her a cuddle as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings, but she won't let me. The Pharisees in our gospel reading are, of course, older than 3 and a half. They have learnt a subtlety that 3-year-olds haven't. Jesus longs to gather them into his kingdom, along with all the Israelites, as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings. But they won't let him. They tell him to go away. They don't yell. They don't grump. They quietly shift the blame onto Herod. Why do they want him to go away? Well, exercising love, genuine love, is not the same as being eternally nice and only telling people what they want to hear. Much as our granddaughter might want another snack, too much of that food at the expense of lunch isn't in her best interests. 2 chapters earlier in Luke's gospel, Jesus has a bit of a rant against the Pharisees. "Woe to you," he tells them, "for putting the detail of the law before the love of God and neighbour." Not with one example, but 6. This maverick preacher, who hasn't gone through the right training channels, is not telling them what they want to hear. Not, of course, because he dislikes them. No, because he loves them. And today's passage clearly shows Jesus's exasperation at their inability to recognize and acknowledge God's love in action. He longs to gather them into his kingdom, as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings, but they won't let him. He longs to gather me into his kingdom as a hen gathers her chicks under his wings. But do I let him? The Pharisees had created barriers. Do I? Do you? What might those barriers be, I wonder? Well, for me, I'm not the best person to ask. Maybe ask my wife. I'm far better at identifying others' shortcomings than my own. Maybe I need Jesus to be direct with me. If he was, would I grump and tell him to go away? Well, not directly, of course. I'd be more subtle than that. I would too often just turn my back, metaphorically, and do my own thing, which would probably be more comfortable than listening attentively to God. Is that subconscious? Maybe. It might be from apathy or from not wanting to be convenienced, or from lack of courage, or from a sense of unworthiness, or simply because I'm not tuned in to God. Which sort of brings us to Lent, a time in which we try to recapture a better relationship with God. I wonder how we do that. If I ponder, as I just have, my own perceived shortcomings, it can, if I'm not careful, put me into woe is me, miserable sinner mode. I'm paralyzed by self-pity and a lack of confidence to be about our Lord's business. A barrier to recognizing, acknowledging, and embracing God's amazing unconditional love for me. Faults and all. So how do I recognize and overcome my barriers? I'm finding Bishop Stephen's Come and See reflections on the Lord's Prayer immensely helpful. If you've not engaged with that yet, I do commend it to you. 3 minutes of pure gold each day with a 6-minute video on Sundays. Thus far, he's reflected on Our Father in Heaven, hallowed be your name. And some of his thoughts speak directly into the theme of this talk. I quote, "We're not here by chance as random collections of atoms in infinite space. We are people, and we are called into a relationship with our Creator. That relationship is defined by love, not our weak love for God, but God's strong love for us, the love of a father for his children, our Father in heaven. God loves you powerfully and personally. God calls us by name into a relationship of love and trust." What are those barriers? How do I get back to that relationship God so yearns for me? How does my little granddaughter get back to harmony with her grandparents? Well, she's developed a coping mechanism. She'll take herself off into the conservatory, sit in the rocking chair, facing the garden, and after a while, come quietly back in. No words, just a quiet hug. And all is well. Quiet time. It's so simple, and yet there seems often a barrier to actually doing it. Perhaps at this time, as we look with horror at what's being done to Ukraine and its people, it behoves us to count our blessings that we can take a quiet time. Bishop Stephen encourages us to be still and know that God is God. In that stillness, we can recall that Jesus instructs us to pray to our Father, not a remote deity. In heaven, yes, but our Father, yours and mine. Longing with his Son, to gather us into his kingdom, as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings. And as we spend time quietly in God's presence, those barriers will diminish. I want to close with a meditation on a verse from Psalm 46. Be still and know that I am God. And after that, there will be a pause before Avril Coleman leads us in prayer. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am. Be still and know that I. Be still and know that. Be still and know. Be still. Be. Be still. Be still and know. Be still and know that I. Be still and know that I am. Be still and know that I am God.
Amen. After each of our prayers, I will say, Lord of Hope. And the response, if you would like to make it, is, hear our prayer. Lord of Hope, hear our prayer. Gathering God, your face is turned towards our world in love and compassion, and you long to draw all people into your kingdom as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings. Forgive us when we resist you, when we put up barriers that stop us receiving the love that you stand so ready and willing to give. Please help us to recognise, acknowledge, and embrace your great and amazing love for us, seen supremely through the death and resurrection of your Son, Jesus. Help us to allow your love to really sink into our hearts and lives, and enable us to do all that we can to communicate that love relevantly and compassionately to others. And please strengthen our love for you and keep our hope in you strong as we walk through challenging times in our world. Lord of Hope, hear our prayer. Mighty God, you are a very present help in all our troubles, and we put our trust in you. We remember before you all who are refugees, all who have been driven out of their homes by violence, war, or natural disaster. We especially remember before you the people of Ukraine in all of their terrible suffering right now. Please may the fighting stop, peace return, and aid get to those who most need it. We pray for the Russian soldiers who do not want to be there. We also pray for the leaders of Ukraine, Russia, and leaders throughout the world, that they will have the conversations they need which will bring about peace. Where hearts are hardened by fear, arrogance, or hurt, may those hearts be changed so that better conversations can happen. Lord of Hope, hear our prayer. Strong God, you are our strength in times of weakness. You are our hope in times of darkness. We pray for all those who are struggling at this time, who are finding life hard and the outlook bleak, all those who have been shaken by what is happening in our world and find it difficult to be hopeful, all those struggling with ill health or worrying how they will pay their energy bills. In a moment of silence, let us hold before God all those who are on our hearts today. Lord, thank you that you see each person who is hurting. Please bring your hope and strength to each one. Lord of hope, hear our prayer. Compassionate God, as we go out of this service and into our daily routines, please help us take time to be still and know that you are God. We need you every day, every hour, every minute. Help us to deepen in our understanding and love for you, to give thanks for moments of stillness in your presence, to rejoice in the new life we see in the emerging spring flowers and new growth. Help us to recognize, acknowledge, and embrace your amazing love for us more and more. Lord of hope, hear our prayer. Amen. Now let us gather all our prayers together in the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Julia, Avril, and Chris, thank you so much for your reading, prayers, and your message. As we draw our service to a close, we're going to sing again. And our final song today is Oh to See the Dawn. Again, in this season of Lent, it's a great reminder of the upcoming excitement and celebration of Easter, the celebration of God's power on the cross. Let's sing together.
Oh.
you so much for joining with us today. Let's finish our time together with a prayer, praying for God's blessing on ourselves and those who we care for. Let's pray. God of compassion, through your Son Jesus Christ, you have reconciled your people to yourself. As we follow his example, may we obey you with willing hearts and serve one another in holy love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.